Hi, my name is Rami Ismail. I'm a game developer. I've been a game developer for most of my life. I made my first game when I was just 6 years old and wasn't very good. I'm now over 30 years old and I've been making games professionally for over 12 years. I actually have two jobs in games nowadays. The first one is I make games. The second one is I help other people make games. And I help big companies make games, and sometimes I also help just small teams of just one of two people make games, sometimes even on the other side of the planet. I've helped a lot of games get made. My name is in the credits of over 100 games, which I'm really proud of, and I've won a lot of awards with my work. It's been a really fun time for me being a game developer. So Global Game Jam Next came to me and asked me to give you a few tips about making games. And luckily, I've learned a few tricks in the past few years. So tip number one, start with the verbs. Verbs, we also call mechanics, and they're the things that the player does in the game. Some games that you play have a lot of verbs, like jump, run, shoot, crawl, build, talk. Every verb takes a lot of time to make. You have to program it, you have to draw it, you have to make sounds for it. Which can take a lot of time. So you want to be a little careful with how many verbs you put in your game. Some games only have a few verbs, and some of those games are really good. Last year, a game with only two verbs won a lot of awards. So you want to focus on those verbs, because verbs are the things the player has to do to play your game. And if what the player has to do in your game isn't fun or isn't interesting, they will just quit the game. And they won't see the rest of it. They won't get to read the story that you want to tell. That would be really sad. Tip number two, do what your team is good at. In the games industry, there are many jobs. You have artists who can draw incredibly well. You have programmers who are really good with computers and can fix problems that nobody else could fix. You've got designers, people that do a little bit of psychology. They figure out how the player thinks and how we can make them do what we want them to do. You've got musicians, you've got people that are really good with sounds, you've got writers, there's all sorts of jobs in the industry, right? Everybody is good at something. So when you pick your teams later on, or if you already have a team, with the team you already have, sit down, talk about what each of you is good at. What is your talent? What do you think is fun? When you're picking a game idea, think of those things and make sure that your game fits the things you're good at and the things you find fun. Tip number three, tell your own stories. It's easy to tell a story about a hero that saves the world, right? But the best games are about stories that are important to their creators. They're more personal, they're more honest, stories that the people that make the game care about. Think of your favorite games or movies or TV shows, YouTubers or influencers, right? They make content about the things they care about, right? And that's because it's why it's fun to watch, because they care about it. And it's actually the same thing with games. If you are honest about what you're trying to tell, if you're telling a story that only you could tell, a story that is important to you, it'll automatically be a better game. And everybody is different, so everybody has a story to tell. Making sure that we see as many of those stories in games from different people, people of different ages, people from different places, people that have different circumstances in their lives. The more different people tell their stories, the better the games get. So if everybody tells their own story, there will be way more stories to play. And who knows what stories we haven't heard yet in video games. And tip number four, have fun and be fun. Game development is a team sport, and like with anything in a team, you will do your best work if you work well together as a team. Your favorite games were made by people that listened to each other, that were kind to each other. Instead of laughing at each other when somebody had a bad idea, they took that bad idea and saw if they could improve it together as a team, right? And instead of being angry that took people that took too long to finish a thing or that didn't do the thing as good as they could have, instead of being angry at them, they worked together to see if they could help out and make the game even better. In the games industry, It doesn't really matter how good you are at your job if you're not a nice person to work with. So we all work in games because we love video games and because we believe it is awesome to make them. This might be your first time making a video game. It might not be. But whatever the case, it's important that today and the next few days that you have fun, that you work together as a team. Go make some video games. I'm going to go to the next one.